Hello everyone. The topic we have taken for today is from chapter 2, Physical Features of India. The topic is Himalayas. Himalayas are the young fold mountains. These are young mountains formed out of the folding activity. Two plates, that is the Indo-Australian plate and Eurasian plate, started coming towards each other, and that led to the formation of Himalayas out of the folding activity. Himalayas run in west to east direction, that is from Indus to Brahmaputra. They also form an arc of around 2400 kilometers. The width ranges from 400 kilometers in Kashmir to 150 kilometers in Arunachal Pradesh. And the average height of the Himalayas, it varies from about 6,000 meters to 900 meters above the sea level in different parts. Himalayas can be divided into three parallel ranges in its longitudinal extent, that is Himadri, Himachal, and Shivaliks. Let us go in details. Himadri. Himadri is the northernmost range of the Himalayas and is also known as the Great Himalayas. It is the most continuous range consisting of very high peaks like Mount Everest, Kanchenjunga, Karakoram, K2. All of these are a part of the first range, that is the Himadri. The average height of Himadri range is 6,000 meters. This range is perennially snowbound. For most part of the year, this range is covered with the snow. The second range of Himalayas is Himachal. This range lies to the south of the Himadri and forms the most rugged mountain system known as the Lesser Himalayas. Here, the altitude varies between 3700 to 4500 meters and the average width is about 50 kilometers. There are many ranges over here: Pir Panjal range, Mahabharat range, Dholadhar range. All of these ranges are a part of this Himachal Himalayas. This range is known for hill stations. Beautiful hill stations like Mussoorie, Nainital, Shimla, Kashmir Valley, Kullu Valley, Kangra Valley, all are a part of this range of Himalayas. Then, children, third range of Himalayas is Shivaliks. Shivaliks is the third range of Himalayas. It is the outermost range of Himalaya, and it is also, that is why it is also known as Outer Himalayas. It extends for over 10 to 50 kilometers, and the width is around 10 to 50 kilometers and the altitude is 900 to 1100 meters. You can see in the map, this is the Shivalik range. This is the Shivalik range. This is the outermost range of the Himalayas. This comprises of the unconsolidated sediments brought down by the rivers. As we all know that Himalayan rivers, they come down from the higher peaks and they bring with them large amount of unconsolidated material. And because of less slope in the Shivalik range, large amount of that unconsolidated material starts getting deposited in this range. The children, the longitudinal valleys lying between the Himachal range and the Shivalik range is known as dunes. They are known as dunes. We have several dunes with us like Dehradun, Patli Dune, Kotli Dune, etc. We can also divide Himalayas on the basis of the river valleys. So let us see the regional division of Himalayas demarcated by the river valleys. In between the river Indus and Satluj is the Punjab Himalaya. These are regional names, children. In Kashmir, people call them as the Kashmir Himalayas. In Himachal, people call them as the Himachal Himalayas. Kumaon Himalayas are between river Satluj and river Kali. Nepal Himalayas between river Kali and river Tista. And Assam Himalayas between river Tista and river Brahmaputra. let us see the last part, the Purvanchal Hills. Purvanchal Hills, these lie beyond the Dihang Gorge and I wanted to show you this. See here, this part of the Himalayas, all of these regions, they are called as the Eastern Himalayas, or you can say the Purvanchal Hills. This range of Himalayas lies behind the Dihang Gorge. Himalayas bend sharply to the south and spread along the eastern boundary of India. Here they are called as the Purvanchal or Eastern Hills. Purvanchal, the word Purv means east. They mostly composed of strong sandstones, which are sedimentary rocks. They also form natural frontier between India and Myanmar. The examples are Patkai Hills, Naga Hills, Manipur Hills, and Mizo Hills. Children, also you would be surprised to know that these Himalayas are covered with thick flora and fauna, and because of less human activity, we have really maintained the flora and fauna of this region. Thank you.